Someone sent me an email the other day and said that Vladimir Moss, the old calendarist, layman, and author, directed that person to a Cyprianite parish. And he also said that clergy in the Moscow Patriarchate infiltrated the RTOC, Russian True Orthodox Church, pushing a Cyprianite agenda. Now, with regard to Moss pointing this person to a Cyprianite Senate and Resistance parish, this is another example of the kind of inconsistency, contradiction, and hypocrisy we see repeatedly with old calendarists. Historically, Moss has viewed the Cyprianites as heretics, so it makes absolutely no sense for him to direct people to a parish comprised of people that are heretics, directly contradicting the fathers of the church who categorically prohibit Christians praying with heretics and schismatics. Canon 33 of Laodicea comes to mind at this point. If you're an old calendar struggling because you don't have a parish to go to, you do what I did when I was an old calendarist, and you say your prayers faithfully at home. You don't compromise. You never, ever compromise. You go to a parish in your jurisdiction that you consider to be true when you can. You take the long drive or you take a plane flight when you can, but you never, ever compromise. You be faithful and true at home, see, like I was. So Moss points someone to a Cyprianite parish makes absolutely no sense. With regard to Moscow Patriarchate clergy infiltrating the RTOC to pushing a Cyprianite agenda, this person didn't prove that claim. I want to mention I try to be as honest as possible. He didn't cite any kind of proof. But it makes sense because I think it would explain the conduct in these clergy and why Father Vladimir Mordvinkin of the RTOC pointing me to a mainstream Serbian Orthodox parish. That's something a Cyprianite would do. And Mordvinkin's behavior on this reveals Cyprianism. And I don't have any proof he is a Cyprianite, but it explains a lot. So let me tell you what happened. Many years ago, when I identified as an old counterist believer, Vladimir Moss directed me to the Russian True Orthodox Church. I Googled them, discovered there are two groups with that name, but not in communion with each other, which makes no sense. It only serves to confuse people, which, if any of those two groups is the true Russian Orthodox Church. Well, the answer to the question depends on who you ask. It's totally subjective. And this is a problem with old calendarism. And anyway, Moss said he recommended the one under Bishop Stefan. So I went with them. I contacted a priest in that jurisdiction named Father Vladimir Mordvinkin. I expressed my interest in going to his church. And he directed me to a parish in the Serbian Orthodox Church mainstream. And the reason he gave was because they were closer to where I live, and they spoke English, if I remember correctly. Those are the reasons he gave. Well, this is just simply outrageous. You don't compromise because it's convenient for you. See, you don't go to a heretical parish because it's convenient for you. You remain faithful at home saying your prayers. At the official level of the RTOC, the Serbian Orthodox Church mainstream is considered apostate and heretical. So Mordvinkin shouldn't have directed me to that Serbian Orthodox parish. Another example of contradiction and inconsistency. And I would argue that the god of a religion that permits contradiction and hypocrisy like this is morally defective, not the greatest conceivable being, not maximally great in essence, not God. Not God. This has pagan overtones. The Christian God cannot permit these kind of scenarios, these kind of things, these, you know, contradictions and inconsistencies and disobedience. Anyway, I emailed Mordvinkin, told him that the parish he directed me to was Serbian Orthodox. He never offered any kind of apology or explanation, never communicated, never contacted me again. Profoundly selfish. I notified his bishop, completely ignored by him as well. And I want to remind people that people in cults are conditioned to ignore complaints about group and leader, according to Stephen Hassan. Read his book, Combating Cult Mind Control. Stephen Hassan was referenced and endorsed by the Archpriest Alexei Young, mainstream, in his article, Cults Within and Without. I'll link to it below in the description box. And I told Moss about what Mordvinkin had done, and Moss asked me if I was sure Mordvinkin was in Bishop Stefan's church. The fact he asked that question reveals that he recognized that this was an egregious violation. It was unacceptable, inappropriate for Mordvinkin to direct me to that mainstream Orthodox parish. So I told Moss yes, and eventually sent Moss a copy of my email correspondence with Mordvinkin. Moss never offered any kind of apology or explanation. My complaint was ignored. Remember the word ignore, pursuant to Stephen Hassan and Archpriest Alexei Young, cultism. And I'm not saying these people are in a cult. I'm not saying the RTOC is a cult. I'm not saying Moss belongs to a cult. But this does suggest, I would argue, cultic indications. It does indicate, rather, a cultic mind frame when they ignore complaints about group. Now, so yes, this is what happened with Moss. And also I want to mention that one time I had told Moss that, you know, these clergy were not communicating, they weren't resolving this issue, something along those lines. And Moss said something which I never forgot, which I always considered audacious. He said something to the effect that if God wanted the RTOC clergy to work with me, he would inspire them to communicate with me, to contact me. First, I want to mention that this is his subjective, fallible opinion, an ideological opinion, totally subjective, psychological. There's not a shred of proof that what Moss was saying was true. There's no proof that God agreed with what Moss said. Secondly, it's bad enough that the RTOC clergy behave this way. So Moss was in essence blaming God for their indifference and their selfishness, which is sinful. And also, we shouldn't wait for revelation from God to tell us how to behave. He's already revealed to us our responsibilities and duties toward our fellow man in the pages of Holy Scripture. See, there is no virtue without struggle. God does not use coercion. It's virtuous to just be a nice person and to help someone out. You don't have to wait for God to tell you to be a nice person. See, no virtue without struggle. And also I want to mention here that one of their priests actually did eventually contact me, and he offered to buy me a plane ticket so I could fly to his parish and go to church. He made the offer. I didn't ask for this. I didn't ask for a plane ticket. He just made the offer. And that was kind for him to do that. But at that point, it was too late. I had already lost faith in the RTOC. So this is just outrageous what Moss said. Just, you know, just be a nice person. You don't have to wait, you know, for God to tell you to be a nice person. God has already related to us in the pages of Scripture how we are to relate to our fellow man. We are to love our neighbors, brothers, and enemies. And again, I want to emphasize that Moss was in essence blaming God for their indifference, their apathy, and their selfishness. And also, in conclusion, it was bad enough that, you know, the RTOC clergy behaved this way. Moss was in essence blaming God for it. This is ridiculous. So anyway, I'm going to give information about the RTOC and Vladimir Moss below in the description box.